So Danny, first chance we've got to sit down and talk with you, so I suppose belatedly, welcome to the club.
Yes,
so tell us a bit, tell us about Danny.
Played most of my football down in Carlow, with St. Pat's Boys, excellent club. Had played a bit of Wexford youth underage for half a year, and ended up going back down to St. Pat's. Had a trail over in Norwich, didn't work out, came back, played most of it, stayed playing football down in St. Pat's, and just ended up back up at Wexford, so I did this year. So happy to be back.
So St. Pat's then, tell us a bit about the club.
Yeah, they're a very good team, so they are. They always compete at a high level down in Carlow, so they haven't won on in the last few years, and unfortunately, but this year they have a very good squad coming together, and hopefully they'll get the silver at the end of the year.
Now, I've been doing a bit of research, I was having a look on various social media accounts and things like that. GAA is a big part of your life, I
believe. Yeah, yeah. Great fun, GAA. Yeah, very big part of my life. I played a lot of football. Still do until I came up here to Wexford. So they're a very good club, great fun, GAA. And again, very good squad, panel this year. They're hoping to push for a championship. So we're looking at hoping for them to do it.
And what made you choose soccer?
Soccer's always been number one. Well, Gael has always been there as well. But just soccer there, trying to make it into the big leagues over in England. It's every soccer person's dream at the end of the day, so I've kind of switched my lines over to that, so hopefully I'm a step in the right direction.
And tell us a bit about Norwich.
Norwich. Went over there when I was 17, and went over there, and I was over there for 2 weeks at the start, and it was a good experience, but it was tough. So it was. It's not easy. You just don't go over there. It's hard to fit in at the very start. You found my ground, and I played one game with them against West Ham. Doing it all, kept a clean sheet, and got called back over. Was over there for another few weeks, and just didn't work out. So I didn't just end up getting asked to leave. So, can we start that again?
No. That's what we're doing, Devin. So, come back home from Norwich.
Yeah.
Back to St. Pat's then, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
And how did it come about ending up down at Wexford FC?
I knew Damien. Damien managed down in Carlow Credit Yard. So he did, and they're a very good team. They've won the last 3-4 years in the trap. So he knew me, he'd seen me play for a couple of years down there as well. And the opportunity came for he asked me to come up, and took with both hands.
And what is it that kind of attracted you to, let's be frank and honest about it, when you signed, we're bottom of the league out of the whole 20 teams. So what kind of attracted you to come and play football?
First division football, so it's you're still playing at a high level, so yeah, it doesn't matter if you're bottom or you're top, like you're still part of a professional setup more. And yeah, and I knew a few lads, Carlow lads are down there, Dean and Mikey, and I know Owen McCormick, and there's some great quality in this squad as well. I've seen that when they trained for the first 2 weeks before they even signed. Huge quality in this squad. It's hard to see that they are bottom, and looking at results and the way things have gone, you can see that they shouldn't be there, but we're going in the right direction, definitely.
So you knew, as you said, you knew a few of the lads before you came down. So obviously that made it a lot easier for you to settle in, rather than coming down and knowing no one, I suppose.
All the lads have been excellent, so the lads have welcomed me straight in, so the lads didn't take me long to settle in at all. Before I even signed, I felt settled, so I did, so I was happy, very happy.
And tell us about the changing room. In there, before a game, you're all sitting around. Who are the jokers in the pack? Who are the ones mouthing? Who are the ones jumping around?
Owen McCormick, definitely. He's a baby joker, so I work with him on as well, so I do. So I know he's cracking the head, so he's in a good way. Everyone around the dressing room, there's always good vibes, so there is, and it's never a dead dressing room. It's always lively, so it is, and everyone up for the match 100%.
So is there ever anybody in there that's sitting down that's quiet, has a different preparation to the rest of the lads? Meditates maybe?
Me sometimes, I like to sit there sometimes and just kind of get into the zone. As you say, that's kind of my way. I wouldn't be up too excited, so I wouldn't, but that's just me. That's how I like to prepare.
You say that, but I've seen a lot of people comment that you're a very vocal goalkeeper when you're on the pitch.
On the pitch is a different story, yeah. I like to dictate things. I think it's a big part of goalkeeping, and I think a quiet keeper, it's your back four needs to know your day, they need to know what needs to happen, so it is during the match. So I think a big part of goalkeeping is communication with your other 10 players, not just your back four. So.
And while we're talking about goalkeeping, preparation for games. We had someone ask the question, Kieran Burke asked the question, when it comes to your preparation for games, do you like to try and study who you're going to be facing, or does it kind of, is with it being the League of Ireland and lack of the First Division, lack of coverage, does it make your job a bit more difficult?
At the minute, kind of, yeah, because most of the lads that played every team already, so they kind of have an idea of who plays where, what positions, who's who. But at the minute, last 3-4 games, I don't really know anything at the minute, so I'm just learning on the job, as you kind of said. When I was back down in Carlo, playing in the Carlo League, you know the players, you know the team, so you can study, so you can, you know what players are capable of. This is just learning my job, so it's a learning experience, the whole thing.
So you kind of maybe answered this question for me now, but another question that was asked, Conor Ruth, he wanted to know, a couple of weeks ago here against Cabinteely, the penalty save for Kieran Waters, at what stage did you decide, I'm diving to my right hand side?
I like to just pick and stick, get down low and hard as fast as you can. It's for some players, as you say, if you know, maybe they're good sides, but strikers are not dumb either. They're smart, they'll know what to do. If they know your side, they might switch it up. Penalties are like a lottery, so it is, you have to pick and stick, I think, personally.
And so you just decide, I'm going to my right hand side and my left hand side.
Get low and hard.
And that's it. And try and push your legs. And love you. There was a great turnout then on Friday against Cabo. So kind of, I suppose, going back a little bit now, young Danny and Carlo, late 90s, who were you kind of looking up to in the footballing world?
Manuel Neuer's always been there, so yeah, he's an excellent keeper, so he's learned a lot. He kind of brought keeping world forward with the sweeper system and what he does. He does it very good, so he's definitely someone you look up to and you try to take things out of his game and bring him to yours.
Try and make you a better goalkeeper.
Exactly, yeah.
Doing that. I want to ask you then, we kind of touched on it earlier on when I was asking you about joining Wexford, but Damien Locke, the boss, the gaffer, number uno, what's he like?
Very young part, so he gets his messages across. He's a very good manager. We have the respect for him. Very good, so he gets his game plan across very well. Very good.
He always seems, when I talk to him in interviews, he always seems very methodical, very well spoken, very calm.
Yeah.
Is he like that in the changing room when the door's closed?
Yeah, no. Won't give too much away, no, but I'm running an extremity.
So we're not like you could hear a teacup smashing or anything like that?
No, it's not like that. We get our game plan, he gets the game plan across very well to the team. Everyone knows when they're going on the pitch what they have to do with their jobs, and that's what you need.
So finally then, what's kind of the hopes and aspirations with Wexford FC? I mean, we're coming close to the end of the season now.
Well, next season, get into pre-season, get pushed down the league and hopefully push on. We've got to get back to the Premier where the club should be, so it should. So that's the aspiration for next year. So
Danny, I suppose all that's left to say is I'm sorry it didn't work out in marriage, but we're really glad you did. Thanks for your time.
Perfect, thanks very much.